Hi all, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to talk about by using AWS provider, how we are going to authentication but your local local machine to in AWS cloud environment. We already discussed previously few of the things to authentication, but the good approach we are going to talk about today. So if you scroll down, if you go to the Terraform document AWS provider, if you scroll down below, you can see so there are a few ways to authenticate to your desktop to AWS account console. AWS provide offer a flexible means providing credentials for authentication. The following methods are supported in order to build the services by using Terraform. So there is one is static credentials and environment variables and shared credentials. If you scroll down below, so the static credentials we discussed earlier. So how we need to make a static credentials. I would like to suggest to please go ahead and watch my previous video. And today also anyway, I'll show you how we need to make using credentials, how we are going to perform. So let me go ahead and build the IAM user. So we have already one IAM user. I don't want. So let's check it out. This one. I'm going to create a new user. Oh, okay, I'm going to keep it as a demo or something called Terraform. So I want programmatic access. Then only would be required to communicate CLI commands. So I'm going to give administrator access. Scroll down. I'll create the user. So I'll discuss what is I would like to say. I'm suggesting to please watch my previous video for more information about. Okay, I have already my previous one. I'm going to replace this one. Go to the show now. So let me copy. So okay, so this is the static one. I'm going to quickly go into my Terraform document. So these are my credentials. So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to use the static credentials provider AWS. I'm using based on the provider, we need to specify the credentials here. So I'm using AWS. So I'm by using IAM management, I create one user. The user I assigned administrator access. So it means the user can do anything by using CLI commands. So I'm going with the Terraform orchestration tool. So now what I will do, I'm on the top of that, I'm going to build one resource. This is called Amazon S3 resource. So I'm using my command line. So where I placed everything, my code. So now what I'm going to do, let me go ahead and run the Terraform init again first. So before I go to run, I have already previous one. This one I don't want. Let me go ahead and delete that one. So actually this one actually, okay, now nothing is available. You can see here there is no other folders available. Let me go ahead and run the first. Let me run the Terraform init. When run the Terraform, it's going to download the required plugins based on the provider. So the provider using AWS. So we can see we are able to authenticate my desktop to AWS console. Now it's going to download the program. Now we successfully complete. Now let me run the Terraform apply command. Terraform apply, stick few seconds. Yeah, I can see now service, the Amazon S3 bucket is able to create. Okay, now if you go back and see there is no Amazon S3 already available. Let me see, go to the S3 console, S3. You can see there is no S3 bucket available. Let me go back and now run the Terraform apply. You can see there is a one this bucket is creating, that is Amazon storage. S3 storage. Now we can see the Amazon storage completed. The creation got completed successfully. Take two few minutes to come out. Yeah, now we can see complete successfully. Now this is the one way to authenticate. We can build the n number of services. This is a way static way. Now I don't want this one. Let me go ahead and destroy. I don't want to this one. So now I'm going proceeding with as per the document. This is the static view. Now go to the environment variables. This is the other way to authenticate your desktop to AWS account. So I'm going to place this link in my description. So then you can take from there if you want. Yeah, now we can see it's going to destroy. Let me say yes. Now if you go back to the console, you can see here the bucket is no more available. The Terraform destroyed. Now this is completed. Now I'm proceeding with the other way. The other way is how we are going to do. If you go to the document here, they mention just to give the provider. And if you come below, this is the stuff provider. Why? Because we need to mention the provider in .tf file. So if I place provider just, I'm not going to pass any credentials here. Now I'm going to export passing the variables locally. If you go to the document here, they're saying the export. Export command is the to setting the environment variable Linux or Solaris, any Linux environment. But when you go to the Windows environment, rather than export, we have to use the set command. Okay. Again, and make sure we don't want to pass any columns here. So if I double columns, we don't want to pass any. So let me set everything. I'm using set AWS access key and my access key and set security key, and I'm setting up the default region which is required for a US2. Now I'm going to run this one all here. Now again, I'm going to this is all done. Now let me go get out, take it to the .terraform file and take it out of the both file. We don't want it to, it is something like a old the previous state. So I take it out everything. Let me run the Terraform, quickly run the Terraform init again. So it's going in. So we are going to pass the new way to authenticate. Now again, I would like to take it out all the old files, .terraform files and everything. Why? Because it's going to store the old previous information. Now I have deleted everything. It was a scratch again. I'm proceeding with a different authentication. Now I can see Terraform init counted successfully. Now again, I'm going to run the Terraform apply to create the S3 bucket by using environment variables. Okay. Environment variables authentication. This will take a few minutes. Now we can see we had output. It's going to create the specific resources. If I say yes, so it's going to create. Let me go back and quickly see the console here. You can see here. You can see the bucket is created. You can see the bucket is created and Terraform command successfully completed. Okay, this is the way to pass the environment variables. So let me go ahead and destroy. I don't want this one. I'll proceed the other way. Terraform destroy. It's taking a few minutes. Okay, now it is completed. Now let me go ahead and run SAS. So it's going to delete the bucket again here. So this is completed. The other way, we have done the environment variables. Please make sure if you're using Linux, please do the export command. Okay. So now again, shared credential. So this is the best approach to pass. I would like to go with the environment variables or shared credentials. What happens is if you use that one, we don't want to specify any hard-coded credentials into the .tf file. Okay. So even when we're trying to push the Git also, we don't want to keep any credentials. Always best approach is shared credentials, the best approach. Okay. Or you can go with the environment variables. But static way is not suggestible. Static credentials, but I'll go. Okay. If you come down below, so this is the shared credentials. How we are going to get the shared credentials? Shared credentials, there is a way. We have to create the profile. How we are going to create the profile? So we need to install the AWS CLI local machine. If we want to install the AWS CLI in your local machine, so if you go and see the installing, I'm going to place, I have already installed my command line prompt. If I enter the AWS, you can see, I can see the output. So it means AWS CLI is already installed. So if you want to follow the installation, AWS CLI, this is the document which you have to follow. There is a .ms file we have to download. Then after that, we have to download. I'm going to place this into the in my description. After uploading my this video into my YouTube, I'm going to place this my YouTube channel description. Then you can click from there. Okay. Now what I will do, now I'm going to run, how we are going to run the, how I'm going to create the profile. Okay. How we are going to profile by using CLI, AWS. Okay. I want to configure profile. F-I-G-R, configure profile. So profile, --profile. So if you don't know the command, if you enter AWS configure, so it's asking for the access and security, but I don't want to go with any default one. So I want to go with the specific one. In that case, I'm going to set it as one name called profile. And my profile name is my AWS. So you can keep it in it, doesn't matter, but I'm keeping it my AWS. If I send enter, so it's asking for the access key. If I go and quickly copy my access key and secret key, let me copy my access key. So I pass it in. Then after that, I'm going to quickly copy my secret key. Then after that, asking for the region. What is the region? Let me copy my region. This is the region I would like to create my services. If you want specific one, you can go ahead and anything. JSON output doesn't matter. You can keep it anything. Now we can see that's complete successfully. Now if you go, there is one file available here. That is home directory after user is available. User home directory. So when you configure root user, you can see root home folder. So home root folder, then it's based and depend upon the it's a default home directory for a particular specific user where you configured. You can see from there. Now if you go and see that there is two files which I created, when you go and open this one, you can see it will come the output, the profile, the profile name and the access key and secret key. Okay, this is the way you have to configure the profile. Now what I'm going to do, so I'm going to quickly run the Terraform. Now so how we are going to use the credentials. Now if I take the provider everything, okay, take this one everything, go to, I'm going to play replace here, take down everything here. Here I don't want, if you want you can specify also, but I don't want, this is not a mandatory. If you use the profile name, what is the profile name which I created, my command line, this is the profile name which I used to. So if I copy this one, place here, so okay, and the region. So in fact this is also not required, but let me anyway place it here, take the my region name, so keep it here. Okay, so doesn't matter if you want to keep, but we have to install the AWS CLI. Okay, that is completed. EOS2. Now run the, let me delete the all the files, which is, let me go ahead and scratch, delete the Terraform file, and these files not required anymore. So let me go back, and you can see only one file available. Now we are going with different authentication, new approach authentication. Let me run the Terraform. Click here, run the Terraform minute now. Now you have completed successfully. Now I'm running the Terraform apply. So we are at disk. I show you already. There is no bucket available. Now I'm going to create with the new bucket by using called shared credentials. So please make sure if you want to use the shared credentials, you have to install the AWS CLI. So go to the AWS CLI, install the AWS CLI, from there, use the command. Yeah, now we can see is able to create, is going to communicate from locally. Now if I say yes, if you go back and see, bucket is creating. Okay. So this is the way you have to run. Even if you say destroy also, if you say destroy, it's going to destroy services. So this is the best ways to, the best way always go with shared credentials, or you can set the environment variable, but static credentials is only for the initial purpose, but it's not recommended for the good approach. Okay, I hope you guys like my video. So I'm going to place all the comments in my description, YouTube description. If you guys like this video, please do subscribe my channel and like this, do the like symbol. Okay. Thank you.